I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Let me ask you this, Robert. It's been, three, 4 weeks since Mikey's last fight? There's all I hear for the last 4 weeks is Mikey spent. Any update on that at all? What's going on?
Well, since Mikey's fight, I haven't really seen him because right after Mikey's fight, I went to Hawaii for 1 week. When I got back, I think Mikey was in Florida with his family. Since I think he's coming tomorrow. That I know for a fact. He's coming tomorrow. So we'll talk more. We'll see what the deal is. You know what? He called me on the phone about all these guys' dates. Aaron, all these guys that are fighting.
Josito.
We talked about Josito. Aaron, Lindolfo, Mike. You know, Lindolfo's gonna team up with the team.
Great, that's good. Virgil's he's very
now,
talented.
Virgil's now in the same management with me. You know, so you know, we do a team where they're protected. Where I'm out, where I fight for them. Mikey helps me and whatever it is. You know, give me dates for all the young guys.
You guys have a lot of experience from every angle as a fighter,
exactly.
As a champion, as a trainer, as a manager.
Yes.
You've seen every quote-unquote dirty trick that people do in boxing.
Exactly.
You already know.
We definitely do it.
Someone new to the sport may not know the landmines, where they come from. You already know when someone gives you a contract, say, we don't want
to
fix.
We know exactly the way it is. You know,
everybody's tricky in this sport,
and
Robert.
We've dealt with everybody, and I know how to deal with everybody. They all
okay, let me ask you this. Why do so many people in boxing have a bad reputation in business? Is it true or is it exaggeration?
Look, let me tell you. At the end of the day, the fighter is always going to blame somebody.
It's true.
And that's the trainer and the manager. So if I'm the trainer, if I'm the manager, one day, look, as of right now, I don't see it. All my guys, they're happy, they love it. I don't see it.
They're happy.
You know what I mean? But...
No, but sometimes they blame a promoter.
It always happens where somebody gets blamed. Right?
Except the one in the mirror. They never blame themselves for not training or...
They never blame themselves for spending all their money. When, my manager
robbed me. Yeah.
My trainer,
Okay, should people read a contract before they sign? Sometimes fighters just sign, they don't even know what they signed. And then,
because sometimes they think, oh, fuck, it's Golden Boy giving me a contract, so let's sign it. Or let's top right now. You gotta sign it, you gotta study it.
Know what you're getting into.
Yeah, of course. You gotta know what you're getting into.
So what advice would you have for young trainers, young fighters who are now just turning pro, getting into it?
When you're a young fighter, just getting ready to turn pro, it's unless you're a fucking gold medalist or you're a young... Fernando Vargas when he turned pro,
or Gervonta Davis with 400 amateur fights,
Oscar De La Hoya, Mayweather, then you could come in and
demand
and call shots.
I want a signing bonus.
Just an average kid that you know that gets a contract by a Golden Boy or a top rank, you know, you're lucky you're already getting a contract. So there's not much you could demand. Plus, they're good contracts. I went through their contract and they're good contracts. With top rank, you know, they know I know, so...
You were a fighter.
We have good contracts. We have good contracts with the kids, you know, good minimums and everything. So now, they don't worry about it, but I'm in just average kids, sometimes they're just lucky to get a contract, so they'll sign it without reading it, because they know
they're
already guaranteed six fights a year. They know they're getting a minimum of $2,500, $4,000 for a four-rounder, you know.
Let me ask you this, Robert. The fighters
they
have.
They're guaranteed.
Is there room for negotiation or no? Like promoters say, take it or leave it, or you could say.
No, there's always room for negotiation. Not every contract is the same. They could negotiate.
As long as it's in reason.
Yeah, if it's.
I mean, don't say you want a minimum of $200,000.
Yeah, of course, no. There are reasonable, and I go through that with my contracts. I negotiate and I work it out. Not every contract is the same.
Let me ask you this, Robert.
You know, the contract that Hector has might not be the same as the one that Adorno has. You know what I mean?
Different fighters, different promoters.
Different fighters,
okay,
different promoters.
When you were a fighter, what's the craziest thing they put in your contract that you took out? Do you remember? Was there anything that really...
When I was a fighter,
there was nothing.
We were just lucky to have a fucking contract, so we signed whatever they put in front of us. We never read them. That's why we made a lot of mistakes. That's why we bounced
from promoter.
If it would have been me now, you know,
you were with Goosen, you were with Oscar, you
Don
were with
King.
Don King,
with Don
you
King.
Were top rank?
Yeah, I would have, no, I wasn't with Oscar wasn't a promoter yet.
I thought he managed you for a little bit.
Well, no, managed, yes, but not promoter.
Okay.
I would have stayed with Top Rank my whole career.
That's your one mistake that you would have done. Why? Why stay with them?
Now I know what Top Rank could do with fighters and what they do with fighters, just like Oscar's doing right now. But at that time, Oscar wasn't doing it. Oscar wasn't doing it.
What did they do different than the other promoters? Do you remember?
Look, it's not that. Look, when you sign with a Golden Boy or a Top Rank, you already know you're gonna have a team, a powerful promoter that's always gonna protect you when you're getting started with 4, 6, 8 rounds.
Give you dates, TV dates.
They're gonna bring you opponents. Anything could happen in boxing. You could lose a fight. That happens. But you're always gonna be the one that they protect. So if you're young and you could already get a Top Rank or a Golden Boy to sign you, then you're in good hands. You're in good hands for the first 3 years where your fights are, you know, you can choose and pick and, oh, give me another one. I'm not ready for this one. Give me another one. And they bring you opponents because that's their job. You're good. Then after 3 years, of course, you got to fight. Josh has to fight now. Josh's been pro for 3 years. His next fight is the real
fight. So let me ask you this, Robert. You're a boxing manager besides being a trainer.
Yes.
Fighters all over the world are going to watch this video.
Yes.
Let's say a big name watches this video and wants you to manage them. Would you do it?
Look, big names... Like what kind of big name? I you know, a big name that's already a big name doesn't need me anymore.
Maybe they do. It makes a difference. Robert, it always makes a difference when you have another person handling. When you're the athlete and you could just focus on your craft, I don't care. It makes it easier to have someone help out with contracts, help out with negotiations, because the fighter can't be the good cop and the bad cop. You're going to get less. So you need someone to fight for you. That's where management helps.
Well, what I do with this, my experiences with these young guys, all these young guys, you know, when it comes to Mikey does his own, you know, of course he brings it up to me and my dad, but, you know, he has the final say. Admiral Mares, you know, Jose Ramirez, they all have their managers, they all have their team. So me, as you know, with all the young ones, and, you know, from Virgil to Tanahara to
Franco, to Isaac.
All these guys, you know, I manage and train them. And as of now, I think I've done a great job. You know, when it comes to the management, I think I already know all the business from Mikey's experiences, Abner's fights, Jose Ramirez's fights, you know, Margarito, Brandon Rios, all those fights that we managed together with Cameron Duncan. You know, I already know how this business is. So when I get there on my own with all these young guys, then I'm already gonna know. But as of right now, I'm still like maybe a year away from that. I don't want to say I'm, you know, big names. Maybe they're better off talking to somebody else.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram @EliSeckbach.